by 7 o'clock to know the five factors in that acronym. Start. The staffing for today. Who's on what apparatus? Are they staffed fully? Are they staffed light? Do they have acting officers? Do they have fully promoted officers? Do they have someone in on what we refer to as constant staffing or overtime? Pay attention to what's around you, because that matters. It's not to say that B shift sucks. What we're saying is that that guy who came in for B shift on overtime, maybe he doesn't work with A shift. Maybe he doesn't know kind of the way we do business. And we can all sit there and say, well, you know, we do everything in a uniform manner, and we do it all the same. We all put our own little spin on that in our fire departments. We do. We all know that. Okay? How about for the volunteer department? Show of hands, who's in a volunteer fire department? About half the room. Okay. So staffing, you might not have a set plan all of the time with your staffing. Put your hands back up if you're a volunteer fire department. Okay? Now, for those people with their hands up, put your hand down if you staff apparatus with your volunteers like on a set schedule. So Friday night, Bill's night, and so a bunch of the hands went down. So the rest is kind of hit and miss. Is that correct? You're not sure. It depends. The tone comes off. You respond to the firehouse, etc. Okay. That may be more difficult for you to know what you're going to get because sometimes it's a crapshoot. But do you know certain things taking place in your city or your organization? How many folks from your department are here at this conference? Do you know the person who's back home, that chief who's running the show today, does he know he's a little short-staffed? Yeah, probably. So just keep that in mind. T, we want to pay attention to things that are ongoing, such as training and special events. Am I going to be tied up doing some type of a drill down at the hospital? My paramedic unit is going to be doing CE down at the hospital, and they're going to be a little bit delayed. Or I'm going to have a whole bunch of equipment out, and they're, you know, it's going to take me a little bit longer to respond to the incident, those types of events. A, apparatus and equipment. Is there anything specific to your department that's out of service right this very second? Your only ladder truck in the city is getting this preventative maintenance. And now I get that firefighter trapped on the third floor of an apartment building, and maybe I don't have a ladder that will reach that as readily. R, road conditions, water conditions, something along those lines. Do I have construction issues in my city that's going to delay my response? And T is temperatures. All those things instinctively, if you don't do it in a formal way right now, right today, you all do it informally in your own brain. You're driving down the road, and you say, wow, look at that, this is road construction. I didn't know the main street was shut down between 1st and 5th. That's crazy. You're not going to slow us down to that incident. So you do it instinctively. What I'm suggesting is that you do it in a formal basis and pass it on to your troops. Tell them what's going on. Accountability. Accountability starts before the incident. In my department, we have three main parts of accountability as far as the system. We have the tags, the passport tags themselves. We have helmet identifiers. And we have SCBA identifiers. So I can look on a fire ground, look at someone from the front or the back, and know what company they're with. And then from there, I have a good idea of where they should be. Now, for instance, this guy in his picture, a couple things that are really good about this particular guy. I know based on my system that this guy is a paramedic, and he is acting out of grade today. He is the acting officer on ladder 45. I know that because of our color-coded system. That's what I know. Now, the bad thing is, this guy was the first new truck officer on a working structure fire, and he is clean as can be. That makes me flipping nervous, because I don't know what the hell this guy was doing. I think he was someplace to hide or something along those lines. We can train a tabletop, and we can continually ask our folks, what if? What if we are assigned as the rapid intervention team today? What tools am I going to grab? What tools are you going to grab? What compartment do we keep that stuff on this particular rig? And we can do that at the beginning of our shift every single time. And we're going to get a lot of good stuff before the call ever comes in.